Hi everyone, my name is Tabitha, and what I want to spend some time doing today is teaching you about contacts in ActiveCampaign. Through our Let's Learn series, we spend 15 minutes or less teaching you not only the strategy, but the technical application of a topic. So today, we're going to break down what contacts are, how they operate within the system, how you can import them, and then we'll dive into a contact profile in the contact dashboard and cover some next steps that you can take to continue your ActiveCampaign learning journey. First, let's touch on our example business. For our example business in our demo, we're going to talk about Boone's Bandanas. Boone's Bandanas is an e-commerce business that sells products for dogs. So they're selling bandanas, harnesses, leashes, and collars, but they also have a nonprofit side to their business in which they donate goods to animal shelters and host adoption events. They're using most of the tools within ActiveCampaign, but today it's going to be important for us to show exactly how they're using contacts and how they've organized their contacts to be most successful for their business. Let's go ahead and talk about contacts. Contacts are defined in ActiveCampaign by a unique email address. So if your contact, Tabitha Hurley, opts in as thurley@gmail.com and hurleytabitha@gmail.com, those will count as two different contacts. Your contacts will be labeled by statuses. Active contacts are ones that have opted in to receive your marketing content, which we'll cover in a bit. Unconfirmed contacts are contacts who have submitted your form but have not confirmed their subscription. They will live in the unconfirmed status until they do so. Unsubscribed contacts are ones that have decided to opt out of receiving your marketing content. They can always opt back in if they decide, but for now, we're not going to reach out to them. Bounce contacts have either been labeled with a hard bounce or a soft bounce. A hard bounce would be the email address has been deleted. A soft bounce would be the email inbox is full. Some things to remember about how contacts work are the following. Contacts must be active and opted in to receive your marketing and email campaigns. It's very important to know that something that's very important to ActiveCampaign is that the people that you're reaching out to through the platform have opted in through either a form or through some previous system that you operated before ActiveCampaign. In order to be considered active, contacts must be subscribed to a list. When your contact opted in, they chose to subscribe either to your newsletter or possibly to your customers list, whatever it might be, whatever form they're submitted, they must be on a list in order to be considered active. Also, active contacts are what counts towards your contact limit. So when you purchased ActiveCampaign, you not only purchased a plan tier, but you also purchased a contact limit. Any of your active contacts are what will count towards that contact limit. So your unconfirmed, unsubscribed, and bounced will not count towards your contact limit. Let's talk about exactly how you can get started with your contacts now that you know the foundational things that are really important. First, we want to talk about importing your contacts. It's very important to know that when you're importing your contacts, your contact list is saved as a .csv file. That will be the easiest way for you to import your contacts into the platform. If you have several columns in the CSV file of your sheet that you're importing, it will be important to align those columns with the custom fields that you've created in your ActiveCampaign account. You'll want to start to map those fields to one another so that the columns in your sheet and the fields that you've created in ActiveCampaign speak perfectly to each other and align with that correct information. Next, choose what list to import them to. Like I said, it's really important to know that when your contacts are coming into ActiveCampaign, you want to subscribe them to a list so that they're considered active. However, if you're importing a list of contacts that might not be active, you can choose at any given time to make them active when you want. Now that you've imported your contacts, it's time to start building and creating some amazing customer journeys. But first, we want to talk about the importance of storing contacts through the different methods of contact organization. We have three different ways in the platform in which you're organizing your contacts. Lists are going to be the top tier way in which you're organizing. Contacts must be on lists in order to be able to be marketed to or sent campaigns. Lists are like a big house. They're big, they're bulky, they're very, very broad. They don't very much change often, so it's very important that you know that the reason that they're on a list is because that's their permanent home. Tags are going to be a lot like the furniture in that house. They can change very easily. They can be rearranged in ways that make the most sense for that room or for that contact. It's very, very easy to update their functionality based on the way that makes sense for the contact and their actions. Fields are going to be changing. They're like the people that are entering or exiting your house. They're very easy to update and manage, and they're the actual DNA makeup of those contacts entering into your house. All of these different ways are things in which you can organize your contacts through. And it's important to note we have Let's Learn series on each of these topics. But for now, let's go ahead and dive into the platform where we can talk a little bit further about how you can set up, organize, and create your contact profiles to make the most sense for you. Now that we have toggled to the platform, you can see that we're in the contact section, which is listed here. You can see that I have 224 contacts that we have imported into ActiveCampaign and have been working with through Boots Bandanas. My contacts are automatically alphabetized by email address, but what you can see is I can start to use these tag, list, and status filters to filter by anything else that makes the most sense for me. If I wanted to see how many out of my 224 contacts were active, I could do that. You can see now that my number has changed by 4, which means that those 4 contacts either live in my unconfirmed, unsubscribed, or bounced section. These are all of the contacts that have actively chosen to opt in that I can continue to reach out to through my campaigns and my automations. My Edit All button is actually a button that allows me to create any kind of bulk actions that I want. So if I was just getting started and I wanted to add all of my contacts, let's say to my master list, I could go ahead, click Add to a List, select my primary contact list, press Add, and Apply. I can apply the changes to all of my contacts at once. So now I know that I've added all 220 of my active contacts to my backup primary contact list. If I wanted to do any other mass actions, I could absolutely add anybody to an automation, add additional tags, or make a mass update to a contact field. If I wanted to filter and then do a bulk update, I could do that as well. I could, let's say, filter by a certain tag and then update a list, or I could filter by a certain list and update a tag. When you're ready, you can actually import more contacts or import your contacts from scratch. When we click on the import button, it's actually going to take us to a page that shows us all of the different platforms that we can import from. Now, as we talked about, we can import from a CSV file, and that's typically the best way to start from scratch. If we click Import from File, we can pick a CSV file and then map our fields together. Let's go ahead and try to do that. We'll type in our .csv file so that we can find our file. We'll click here and we'll click Open. As it processes our import, we can start to think about all the custom fields that we've created. You can see here that we have different kinds of fields that are mapped from the actual CSV. I can then start to map them to each other through the custom fields that I've created in ActiveCampaign and the fields that I've created in my form to match. You can also see I can add them to a list. So if I wanted to successfully add them to the primary contact list, like I just did for the contacts that existed in my platform, I could do that. I can also add any additional tags that I'd like, but I would recommend doing this more strategically as you're working through your tag manager. Most importantly, you can choose whether or not you want to import them as active, unsubscribed, or excluded. If you think that there might be contacts that are on your existing list that maybe you're just bringing in some updated information, you can choose to update existing contacts while importing, which means that you're simply updating information that already exists on contacts that are already in ActiveCampaign. If we go back to contacts and decide to not complete our import for the time being, another thing that's important to know is that you can add contacts one by one. You can click on Add a Contact. You can type in your contact's first name, last name, email address, phone number, select an account if there's one that's important for you, and then type in your job title. If you want to display your custom fields and add that information in right here, you can absolutely do that. If that's not important for you to do right now, you'll go to the next step, which allows you to add them to any of your lists, create a deal for them, automatically input them into an automation, add tags, or do any additional actions. Once you press apply, the contact has now been uploaded into your system. You can see that our number went from 224 to 225. Another tool that you have in your contact section is going to be using the search bar to locate specific contacts. You can see here's the contact that we just uploaded, but we're going to focus on this contact for our demo. Now that we're in the contact profile, you can see all of Tabitha's information, whether it be basic information that you collected when she signed up or the information that you've been collecting on along the way. You can see all of her custom fields, most importantly, her tags, her lists, and the automations that she's entered. Here's all the different tags that apply to Tabitha. This is really truly the DNA makeup of your contact. This is where everything that you have collected on her is stored. And it's managed here as well and actively lives and breathes as tags get removed, added, as she enters or finishes automations, and as she subscribes and unsubscribes from lists. You can see that she was subscribed to animal shelters but has since unsubscribed. She now belongs to these three lists in these six automations. And if you continue to scroll down, you can see some additional information on how we've grouped her custom fields to really make sure that the contact profile stays organized. Pet information is very important to Boone's Bandanas, as that's how we communicate with our contacts. So to have these custom fields organized and very much so in their own category makes a lot of sense for our business. You can do the same in your custom fields. As we continue to scroll, we can see that we have a few more groups. We also have our e-commerce deep data integration set up through Shopify. And then we have any tasks, notes, emails, or conversations through our conversations tool that live with Tabitha right here. So we're really encompassing all of the information with Tabitha that extends through the platform in the contact profile. On the right-hand side, you can see her recent activities. So some things affiliated to her deals, some tasks, deal notes that were added. You can see that she's completed some automations, entered some automations. She received a campaign. She reached an automation goal. If you want to, though, continue to look through these activities but filter by them, you can filter by any of these options at any time. If you're looking to see when she started getting tracked on her site, you can see that. If you're looking to see campaign activity, you can absolutely check that box as well. Now that we have completed our demo and our walkthrough of contacts, we want to go ahead and talk about some next steps. We would recommend that you'd sign up for office hours. There's so many different things that you can learn in ActiveCampaign that you might be learning from our accelerated onboarding or from our Let's Learn series, even possibly from our Ask Away videos. But go ahead, sign up for office hours if you have questions that you want to specifically ask a member of the education team. Joining our community will not only allow you to interact with employees of ActiveCampaign, but also allow you to act with customers just like yourself. Subscribing to our YouTube channel will allow you to see all of these videos like Let's Learn, like Ask Away, and any other webinars that we've hosted. Otherwise, we thank you so much for joining us today, and we can't wait to see how you get to building your contacts. Talk to you soon.